Hello, welcome back to the channel, and today I am making a video based off a recommendation, and it was a very good one. Someone was asking, do you have recommendations for shorter books? Which, fair, I don't read a lot of short books. I read a lot of long books, because that's what happens in fantasy and sci-fi. Like, 80% of the time, it's like, you're less than 600 pages. Like, are you even a fantasy book? But there are actually really good, solid sci-fi and fantasy books that are like, short. My definition of short is going to be between like 300 and 350 pages for this, maybe like 250 to 350, because I think once we get below 250, we're more into my definition of a novella, and once you're getting above 350, you are a longer commitment book. So I have a stack here in front of me of books that I think are great in science fiction and fantasy that are shorter, and they are not bad because they are shorter per se or anything like that. They are actually quite wonderful and great palate cleansers between those huge tomes. If you're like, I don't need a tome today, there's a book in this stack for you. So let's get into it. The first one we'll talk about is Gods of Jade and Shadow by Silvia Moreno Garcia. This one's not one that I talk about a lot on the channel, probably because like it's not my favorite fantasy book, but it has so much going for it. This is a 1920s historical fiction fantasy that takes place in Mexico. We follow Cassiopeia. She accidentally wakens a god of the dead and because of situation has to follow him to basically complete a task so that she makes it out of this in one piece. And you get to really explore Mexico in the 1920s, which is really great. I love the Mayan influence in this. Silvia Moreno Garcia has a really lovely writing style, and I think Cassiopeia is a really great protagonist to follow. And this book is like 300 some pages. Let me look and tell you exactly how many pages it is. Like 330 with a glossary, if you require such things. And this cover is stunning. And I like it. So here's our first recommendation. Oh. It's a standalone. So if you wanted a standalone short fantasy, here you go. The next one I think is the longest on the pile. It's like 340 pages, and that is Phoenix Extravagant by Yoon-Ha Lee. This is also a standalone fantasy, and it's about this painter, Jebby. They just want to paint. That's all they want to do in life. They just want to paint and be paid to be an artist because that's what they are. But there is a lot of unrest in this world. It kind of mimics 20th century Korea and the occupation it went through. But Jebby's kind of ignorant of all that. They just want to paint. And in the process, end up with a job with the government, having to work with the War Machine Dragon, who is a very bad War Machine Dragon. They're actually a pacifist. And the story kind of goes from there. I really loved so much of this story. I think it has an interesting ending. Not my favorite ending, if I'm being honest, but the journey up to the ending, Jebby, the dragon, just everything, the magic system with the paints, and how it kind of is a little bit more like sci-fi fantasy, where you have mechs. Like, this dragon is fantastical, but also a mech, something that was built and created that runs off of, I believe, steam power? Unsure. I cannot remember the specifics because I mostly was just interested in all of the dragon's thoughts. So here's another one, standalone, on the shorter side. The next one is one that I read recently and I really like to have a review for it, and that is The Space Between Worlds by Makea Johnson. This is a great standalone science fiction. It has the multi-world theory in it, so that's a science theory we have based off quantum mechanics. In this one, there are like 300 some parallel Earths we could go to if you are dead on that other Earth. If you're alive, you can't do it. And our main character, they're dead on many worlds, and their job is to literally just go to these other worlds and acquire information for their company. And in the process of doing her job, she learned some information, and things happen. I have a whole review. This is definitely a great palate cleanser when you have been in a lot of like slow-paced books. It's definitely on the faster end, and it's only 320 pages. I will say though, it was slower for me than I expected, but it was also what I liked about it. This is a very tight work, and that was really impressive to me because it's a debut as well. Like, the amount of care that went into using every theme and every character moment I thought was fantastic. So like I said, I have a review, I have a lot of thoughts, it's really great. So here you go, a short standalone science fiction. The next one is actually my favorite read of 2021, and that is The Best of All Possible Worlds by Karen Lord. I love this author. Everyone is sleeping on this author. Her prose are everything to me. And this is an optimistic science fiction. So if you've been needing more of that in your life, pick this up. It starts off with a very tragic premise. We have a planet that is no longer able to be occupied by these people. They are displaced. They cannot live there anymore. And this other planet accepts them as refugees and works to figure out, how can we coexist together? How can we keep what makes you guys, yourself, your culture, but also respect what is already here? Such a concept. And in the process, we have this team of scientists, some from this culture, some from the current planet, traveling the world, and I love the team. And it's like so found family. It's so slow burn romance. I love it so much. I cannot wait to reread it. This book's great. I read it in a weekend nonstop. Could not put it down. It was exactly what I needed when I picked it up in February, so I hope someone else finds the joy that I did in this work. I guess since I've already talked about Karen Lord, I will also mention Redemption in Indigo. This is the first work I read from her, and it's actually her debut. It is 280 pages. Very great. This is a folktale Caribbean retelling, and I love it. The writing is so funny. It's so fourth wall breaking. I loved it from the first sentence. This book is everything to me. I love folktale retellings. I love a story that knows it's telling you a story. I love Caribbean-inspired stories. If any of those things are your boxes, check this out. But it also has, like, the grouchy old immortal being kind of trope in here, if that makes sense, you know? Like, a trope we've seen many times in young adult fiction, but, like, for the adult reader, if that makes sense. Highly recommend. This is just, like, such a good palate cleanser when you need something uplifting and funny and different but familiar, if that makes sense. Really, I just need you all to read Karen Lord. That's what this video is all for, me to show you Karen Lord's works. Although the next one is a series, it's not a finished series. I need more in this series, please, Rebecca Roanhorse, and that is the Sixth World series with Trail of Lightning as the first book and Storm of Locust as the second. This is like 280 pages, 290 pages. Really quick. You follow Maggie. She's a monster hunter. She's a reluctant hero. She has a very funny, witty sidekick named Kai. That is my favorite partner combination. I love it. There's a reason why it happens on TV all the time. It's my favorite. There are mysteries afoot. This is a future dystopian fantasy where most of the world is underwater now, except for the Denata land and Utah, that part of the United States. And she now has clan's powers, and so do a bunch of other people, and her clan's power make her very good at monster hunting. This is great. The follow-up is also wonderful with great found family. They are really great, quick reads. Highly recommend them. And then the last one we'll talk about is the Winter Night Trilogy, specifically The Bear and the Nightingale as the first book. They're all about this length, all about 320, 350 pages. I think maybe potentially shorter in the paperback form. They are great. I want to cozy up and read something atmospheric for their weekend reads. They are lyrically so beautiful in their writing in terms of atmospheric descriptions. It's like a fairy tale for adults. Vazia is the hero. She is so wonderful. She has to overcome so much. This is 14th century Russia inspired. There is magic she has to overcome. There is societal norms she has to overcome. It's also winter, like, all the time, and winter is just not easy, like, even if you're just reading a normal historical fiction. I love the series. I have a review for the whole trilogy. I feel like I'm not giving it justice right now, but just know, if you've, like, heard of this all the time, and you feel daunted because people always say trilogy, this is actually really short. All three books together is shorter than the first book in the Stormlight Archives. So I highly recommend it. You know it's almost summer, so maybe this is not the time of year. But it is a short fantasy work. And this one can work as a standalone if you just wanted to try it. It will leave you satisfied, in my opinion. So those are the works. Those are all the books that met my qualifications of like less than 350 pages for a short science fiction fantasy work. If you have any suggestions, let me know down in the comments. And for your emoji, I don't know. Let's leave like a hummingbird for like the best of all possible worlds, or any bird. I don't know if emojis have hummingbirds. That might be too specific, but work with that, and like if you liked it, subscribe if you want to, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.